Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 5.2, Problem 9. This is Section 5.2, Problem 9. It says, Curtis is 28 years old. He wants to have $1 million by the time he is 65 years old so he can retire and not just work until he dies. How much does he have to save every month at 9% compounded monthly in order to achieve his goal? Now again, this is a sinking fund problem. The reason it's a sinking fund problem is because you know the goal at the end and you want to calculate how much you have to save on a regular basis. In this problem, it's every month, sometimes every year, or every week, or whatever. This one's every month. So the sinking fund formula is P equals A over some brackets, and in the brackets there's a numerator and a denominator. In the numerator you have 1 plus R over M to the M times T power. There's a minus 1 after that, and R over M in the denominator of the brackets. And we'll fill that in. So we'll have P equals A on the top of the formula is the $1 million. So it's going to give me a 1 with 6 zeros. That's a million. And then underneath the million, we have the brackets. And in the numerator of the brackets, 1 plus R over M in parentheses. So that's 1 plus R. The rate as a decimal is 9%. 9% as a decimal, I should say, is 0.09. And then under the R is an M, which is how many times compounded per year. So this is monthly compounding. My M is going to be 12. That's in parentheses. I close the parentheses. The parentheses have an exponent of M times T. The M, again, number of times compounded per year is 12 for monthly compounding. And now, the T, number of years. Again, T is not 65. That's when we're going to stop the savings. But we don't start at birth or at age 0. We're starting at age 28. So 28 plus 37 is 65. The value of T is 37. It's a pretty long time. And after the parentheses, there's a minus 1. In the denominator of the brackets, we have R over M again. The R, like I say, is the rate as a decimal. So this problem is 9% as a decimal, that's 0.09. And under the R is an M. M is 12 for this problem because we have monthly compounding. So that fills the formula in. Now we get to work. We're going to start the computation. Again, we start in the parentheses. You just have to. That's the rule. So P equals, you're going to have 1 million in the numerator of a very large fraction. And under the 1 million, you have some brackets that have a fraction within the brackets. In the top of the fraction in the brackets, the 1 plus 0.09 over 12. This number has come up before. 0.09 over 12, I know, divides out to 0.0075. And if you don't remember that it does, I'll just write it near the problem here. 0.09 divided by 12 can be done on your calculator, and the calculator will tell you it's 0.0075. Now, in the parentheses, there's a 1 plus in front of that 0.0075, so when you do that math, it's 1.0075. So I have 1.0075 in parentheses to an exponent of 12 times 37. So 12 times 37, I'm doing it right, is 444. Again, 10 37s is 370, so then two more 37s would be 74, so 370 plus 74 more should be 444. And after the parentheses is a minus 1. And again, those big multiplications, just feel free to do that on your calculator. You don't have to try and do it in your head. And in the denominator of the brackets, 0.09 over 12 again, which again reduces to 0.0075. And I always point out, you have the same decimal in the numerator and the denominator of the brackets. In the numerator, there's a 1 in front. In the denominator, there isn't. But the decimal part is the same. Now, what happens at the next part of the problem is I have to do the computation for this very, very big exponent, 1.0075 to the 444th power. So when I get the answer for that, I'm going to have 1 million in the top of my formula. And then when I fill out the problem, there's brackets underneath. And let me figure out, have the calculator help me figure out what that is. 1.0075 exponent 444 equals, So in the numerator of my brackets, I have 27.59334411. And after that, there's a minus 1. In the denominator of the brackets is still 0.0075. So the next part of the problem, I'm going to have P equals 1 million in the top of the formula still. Then I'm going to have some brackets, and in the top of the brackets, I'm going to do the subtraction 27.59334411 minus 1, which will give me 26.59334411. And in the denominator of the brackets, I still have 0.0075. So the brackets are almost down to one number. To finish the brackets, I'm going to divide the 26.59334411 divided by 0.0075. And when I do that, I'm going to have 1 million over, let's see what I get. So to be 1 million over 3545.779215. And now to finish the problem, I do 1 million divided by 3545.779215. And I always say you can just clear the screen and enter 1 million divided by 3545.779215. But why clear the screen to enter the same number again? Save it in your memory, and then do a million divide by recall memory is much easier. And the answer I get is 282.025456. So now is the point in the problem where I round it off. I'm at the end. My answer is $282 point some stuff, and I don't want to have six places after the decimal. It doesn't do me any good. So I want to just have two places after the decimal because they only figured out how many cents you have. So the 0.025 something is enough to make it 0.03 or 3 cents. So my final answer for this problem is $282.03. So that means the person in the problem, who I happen to name Curtis, he's 28 years old now. If he saves $282.03 every month at 9% compounded monthly, by the time he's 65, he'll have $1 million.